Three Daughters of Eve by Alif Shafak. Part 1. The Handbag. Istanbul, 2016. It was an ordinary spring day in Istanbul, a long and leaden afternoon, like so many others, when she discovered, with a hollowness in her stomach, that she was capable of killing someone. She had always suspected that even the calmest and sweetest women under stress were prone to outbursts of violence, since she thought of herself as neither calm nor sweet. She had reckoned that her potential to lose control was considerably greater than theirs. But potential was a tricky word. Everyone once said that Turkey had great potential, and look how that had turned out. So she had comforted herself that her potential for darkness too would amount to nothing in the end. And thankfully fate, that well-preserved tablet upon which was engraved everything that happened and was going to happen, had for the most part spared her from wrongdoing. All these years she had led a decent life. She had not inflicted harm on a fellow human being, at least not deliberately, at least not lately, except for engaging in an occasional bit of gossip or bad mouthing, which shouldn't count. After all, everyone did it, and if it was such a monumental sin, the pits of hell would be full to the brim. If she had caused anguish to anyone at all, it was God, and God, though easily displeased and famously capricious, was never heard. To hurt and to be hurt, that was a human trait. In the eyes of family and friends, Nas peri nal beng tolu, Perry, as she was known to all, was a good person. She supported charities, raised awareness about Alzheimer's, and money for families in need, volunteered at retirement homes where she competed in backgammon tournament, losing intentionally, carried treats in her handbag for Istanbul's copious stray cats, and every so often had them neutered at her own expense, kept a close eye on her children's performance in school, hosted elegant dinners for her husband's boss and co-workers, fasted on the first and last days of Ramadan, but tended to skip the ones in between, sacrificed a handmade sheep every Eid. She never littered the streets, never jumped the queue at the supermarket, never raised her voice, never when she had been treated rudely. A fine wife, a fine mother, a fine housewife, a fine citizen, a fine modern Muslim she was.